Are you able to see?
Sir,
Yes.
Sir, at what time presentations will be started?
Now 8:30. We will start after 20 minutes.
Okay.
Now you can also do that. That's why I have given that option to you people. You can start now itself, and you must have prepared yourself for 3 persons already. You must have loaded your PPT here itself or whatever, in so many ways, so that everybody can access to that. Anybody can play or anybody can share it. Meanwhile, you do that. You have that 3-4 persons. And after 10 minutes, then we will start our presentations. Okay. Now, welcome back to our class of 29, lecture number 29. I hope you are able to see this slide. And at the same time, this board also, I hope you are able to see our board. And now board may not be very clear because I shared with the slides. Okay, we'll continue with the slide for some time and later we'll discuss. And you stop me at 8:30, then you'll have 3-4 presentations as decided by as a part of assignment and evaluation. Welcome to this lecture 29. We are discussing about our longwall mining methods related issues. Today I would like to give some more intricate issues of problems faced in longwall also. And one of the main problems was with hard roof management, hard roof which could not be caved properly, and that led to so many failures, I should say, as far as application of longwall mining in India is concerned. So I will be showing you how that was tried to face a type of problems, how this induced caving was practiced. That issues also we will see for that case study mine. Ultimately, when it is a coal evacuation process, when you see, first what we are doing in longwall, coal cutting is done by the shearer. And while explaining this also, let me also tell you, it is a totally mechanized mine. That's why coal cutting is also done by other than drilling and blasting. Otherwise, semi-mechanized mining, we call it as a semi-mechanized when this coal cutting or coal preparation, you can say the word coal preparation, is by drilling and blasting, then that is semi-mechanized, where we were using even our SDLs, LSD, scrapers, gathering arm loaders, and so many things. When it comes to totally mechanized, means you are cutting it. So in longwall with shearer, in continuous miners, we are using continuous miners also for other purpose. Even plow can be used, as we have seen, discussed a little bit. And then road headers also can be used. So like that, there will be road headers of different type, boom type or whatever. There are 2-3 types. Then after getting the coal, now through AFC, armored flexible conveyor, now it is going to your stage loader in between, and which is also having a crusher. Already you understood why it is required, and its specifications also we have seen. From there it is going into the gate belt, and then through that, this is in the main gate, tail gate, whatever is the along the longwall panel, it is going to the belt conveyor. Maybe 1.5 meter, 1.2 meter, 2.5 meter width of the belt conveyors. And then trunk belts, through that it is going even up to the surface, or maybe having different arrangements of total coal evacuation process. So now this is how it appears when you see in the gate roads on both sides. Already I have shown so many photographs, but this is for that Southeastern Coalfields Limited, whatever the mine we are trying to see in that Bishrampur area, or Balrampur mine and Kumda and all those mines. So here you see bolting is also there here, and then hydraulic props, right? When it is having looking like this, then you must be knowing this is what is this? Is it a rope bolt, cable bolt, or what is this? Can anybody say? Whatever you are seeing this, what type of bolt we call?
Resin grouted bolt.
That is true, but here when it is a simple roof bolt, so there will be a bearing plate and then nut and so many things. This is a cable, that's why it is protruding outside. So cable bolts are used when we need more length in the roof, more than height of this, whatever is the height. Suppose if this height is around 3 meters, 2.7 meter, in this mine 2.5, 2.7, then beyond that 2.7 meter height of roof bolt is required, for example, right? Why it is required? In the roof section, there may be weaker horizons which are supposed to be supported for long-term stability, especially when we are installing the face, or these gate rods are supposed to stand for the total life of that long wall pan. So that's why we are supposed to make it more stable. That's why we use even cable bolts also. That is what is a cable bolt. Since it is flexible, you can have even 10 meter long cable bolt also. This type of issues you can just note down somewhere. And as I told you, this is hard roof management when it is very difficult to cave, and which already you understood, I used to explain, especially in southeastern coal fields where there is a sill. And that means this is your coal seam, and over that there is a sill of 30, 70 meter thick, and then that is almost impossible to break, right? And now for caving process, if it is not breaking, then what will happen if this this extracted area is not getting filled? Then your load on the face or rear front abutment loading will be so high, and you will be facing a lot of strata control problems, and we have to even close down the face. Many times that happens, and happened also. So we have to do something, and that is that you can also blast from underground to the surface. That is one way of doing that. Otherwise, that can be from the surface, you can make the holes and then blast it. And how these people have done, just you see, that is for de-stressing this overlying strata. That is for induced caving. So before that, just I don't know whether I must have shown you at that time, along the main belt gate, you can see that power train, energy train, whatever the name they give, where power packs and all other motors, other system is there along the gate roads. This is the way how it appears. Of course, this I kept just for the purpose of inducing some thought in you. Now, there is some word like four poling, which is the requirement. You must have heard about this because the terminology you read in your previous semester itself. You think over, meanwhile I discuss, right? Because this is, what is the meaning of four poling, where you heard about it, okay? Now let us continue. About this, yes. Now with experience on this strata, adverse strata behavior, what was experienced in that mine, then here what happened is, you may note down few points which will be useful for us or for you also, just to have some idea. Yield pressure of the supports, that is yield pressure, is increased from 35 MPa to 40 MPa. You just note down. This is corresponding to about 440 tons. If you convert this into 9.8 or whatever like that, around 440 tons to 500 tons capacity. So this support capacity was also enhanced, right? That is, this can be done by even changing that wall, that whatever is the yield wall in the support. Already you have seen how that support system works. There it is, hydraulic pressure, hydraulic oil, already in the last class also we have seen, it seems. Otherwise also it is refreshing for you. In the hydraulic support, there is a hydraulic oil, that is SS oil, and so many names are given to that, where there is a cylinder and then the piston. And here, this cylinder, when there is a load coming on that, this piston will be moving. That is nothing but, in our mining terminology, we are calling it as a leg. This leg closure, we are measuring it, okay? And then this leg closure will happen when it is allowing to yield. So when I set at some pressure, and above the setting pressure, if there is a load coming from the roof, then only that will yield, that will start coming down. And then this yield, whatever happens, right, that can be set mechanically by the yield valve pressures, whatever it is, that is what is the meaning of this. When you read this, even in the books also, it will be written like that. And that is corresponding to the capacity of that supports. So if it is 100% of that yield, that means it is 500 tons. That is a 50-30 kilonewton around that. And now this can be increased mechanically. That's what is the meaning of this, what was made, so that they can take care when there is more hard roof. Let me also tell you once again, when there is more hard roof, right, which is not caving, this leads to more load on the supports, which is affecting our performance of long wall face. That is the meaning why they also increased and tried to do so many things, right, to reduce front abutment pressure at advanced headings, whatever. Then for better support strata interaction at the face and at advanced headings, so this hard roof management is required. That is the meaning here. Then this length of overhang in the worked out area was planned to reduce by induced caving. So what is the meaning of this? This it is better to explain through the figure here. Let me just make it here. Let me explain you through this, since we are having this facility of our, yes. Right. Now I am making it full screen so that you can see what is the meaning of this hard roof management and what type of problems faced and how this induced caving was required and how it was done in that mind. In this, whatever we are discussing about, when you see, this is our long wall floor of this. I hope you are able to see, otherwise you can ask me. And now this is a total height of our long wall. And then this is your chalk shields, whatever are there, two leg, four leg shields, shield supports, and this is your gove. Now here, whatever we are discussing in this as a hard roof management, or which pose lot of problems in India, especially in those mines, as we discussed, including the Chacha mines and Southeastern Coalfields, where there is a sill. That means this is very hard roof, and this roof, it is very difficult to cave. And when this is bridging in the roof horizon, this causes lot of load to act onto your supports and faces. And even as a front abutment, when you see as a front abutment, that is more load will be acting onto the face. When this is a face, when you consider this as a face, and more load will be acting on this. And when you have a red color, of course, no problem. This is your face. And here, what is done? What is supposed to be done? This one, when it bridges for a long distance without caving, then this poses lot of stress coming onto the, especially we are more concerned at the face, in this face, and more load onto the front abutment, and this causes even crushing of this face also, long wall face. And you should remember that crushing at the face, it may help you even in easy cutting like that, but it causes lot of problems in maintaining. That is the reason why in the last class also I showed you there is even a face sprags when there is a spalling tendency. That's why we use this as a face sprag. I think in the last class also I explained this. Face sprags are also there. As far as this hard roof management is concerned, now from the surface, if it is a surface, now from the surface I can make holes like this, and then I can break this with the explosive, so that what will happen now inside the gove, right? Now you cannot enter from underground inside the gove, but now you can go to the surface, and then here already some holes are made, and now you can, even you are blasting this, this length of total overhang will be reduced. Now I blasted up to this, so this much is pressure relieved. That is, this is now almost like a stress-free. That is what is the meaning of de-stressing, which is written in this slide. And I hope you must have understood from there. It is a front abutment load depending on the bridging, whether it is overlying, immediately overlying, and then if not immediate, it can be some more after 10 meters, after 20 meters, right? And this is a sill, whatever is there. Then this is not breaking and not participating in caving process. So you are inducing, with induced blasting, you are inducing caving of that. So that this length of this overhang, it should be to the minimum possible so that this causes less load onto the supports as well as onto the front abutment or in the face, so that you are very working in a stable and safe conditions at the working face. That's what is the meaning of this. Now, coming back to the screen here, I hope you are able to see the screen. Then, for that purpose, the surface deep hole blasting was done, and how it is done. Now you can just see here how it is done. The length of overhang is to be maintained by around 15 meters so that there is seldom any possibility of excessive load transference on supports at the face. And this even estimations of support resistance and all also we'll be discussing towards the end of the semester or at the same time when some of you, our beloved students, are presenting their assignments also, I will add some more materials. Now you have to remind me at around 8:30, right? Now it is 8:29, after 1-2 minutes, right. So now you may note down what was done for this deep hole blasting from the surface. You just note down few important issues, especially diameter of the hole, 100 millimeters, and the depth about 35 to 40 meter it was made from the surface. And of course, this is the pattern what they followed, because here it is not to fragment the total rock, but it is to break and create some cracks, right? So 10 to 15 meter distance of bottom of hole with the coal seam is around 10 to 15 meters, and interval of rows around 15-20 meter, distance between the hole 3 meter, 5 meter, 8 meter. This is how, and the type of a deck blasting was done. And you know what is the meaning of deck blasting and or even air deck blasting. Achha, charge per hole you note down, 50 kg. And here itself, I would like to just show you. Let me show just for a minute what is that pattern and how it was done. Then it is easy for us, right? So with respect to on the plan, when you see, so this appears like this from the surface. Now holes are made. This is a 150 meter is a face. And the length of the face. And then this is along the panel. There are giant pillars on this side. Now how these holes are made, now you can see at 8 meter interval, 3 meter interval in between 8 meters, right? And then from the working face, whatever retreating long wall face is there, around 15 meters, right? At that time, they made a blast from the surface, right? How it was done. This is a pattern. You can also take a snap and keep it for yourself, right? And here, this is around 8 to 11 meters, whatever is maintained from the working faces. And this is your blast hole cross section, about 35 to 55 meters. And you just note down few points here, or you can also take a snap of this like this. And since it is already recorded and YouTube links are made available by all the students, yourself, and shared with me also, all those things will be helpful for everybody. Now, this is on the surface completely cemented. At the bottom, aggregate material and cement, water, so that inside if there are any cracks and other things, it should not be through. That's why it is done like this. And bottom deck charge is around 27.8, 10 cartridges used. Around 3 meter, and middle stemming, and then top deck charge around 24 meters, and remaining is a stemming. This is the way it was done. And explosive, they used aquadine, right? And of course, these are other details. And I don't want to teach you what is explosive and what is blasting. Already you read about the explosives. And here I would like to stop. I think now it is 8:30, and now let us continue with your presentations. But before that, one small query here. Your next CEP, right? What is your next CEP? CEP is CEP 2. Why deck blasting is required? Anywhere. You heard about this, right? It can be air deck blasting or whatever. Okay, you think over then. Meanwhile, I am stopping sharing my slides now, and let me take attendance once again. And let us continue with who are presenting now. I'm stopping sharing. Somebody has given out 4 polling. Now you can open and tell. Unmute and tell.
Sir, I want to answer the first CEP.
Swami. Yes.
Sir.
Yes. Sir. Sir. Meanwhile, who are ready, they can start sharing the slide.
Sir, I'm Rajesh, and I want to answer the first CEP.
Yes, so while answering, you answer it, and others who are already scheduled for today, let them share their slides. Continue.
Okay, sir. Sir, four polling is a method of securing the loose ground, like watery ground or sedimentary ground, and it is a method in which pointed poles of steel and timber are planted on the ground to secure it, and the entering method is usually tunneling to the mine.
Right. So now, as far as our anybody else want to, whatever sharing the slides for that PPT, who are the 3 persons? Meanwhile, we will be discussing it. Who are number 1? Because already it was decided. If they are not ready, let us go to the next, keeping 0 for them. CR to coordinate.
Sir, I will share Chandan.
Chandan is doing now. Okay, Chandan, you share it. Meanwhile, I will talk something about this. Chandan, yes. Assignment. Presentation. Ajay, who has given answer? Our Swami. Swami gave nice answer.
Sir, Rajesh, I gave the answer.
EP1.
Yes, sir.
Swami, you are Swami, right? Rautu Kumar Swami.
No, sir. No, sir. Sir, yes. Rajesh gave the answer.
Sitting message box, sir, and Rajesh.
Rajesh, okay. Good answer. Now for Langwal, let him share. Meanwhile, let him do their assignment, sharing their slides. And here others can note down. In Langwal mining, we used to have even 4 polling, and 4 polling, as he said rightly, for tunneling and even for our shaft sinking. So many places you must have read about it. And for Langwal mining also, now since your support, it is very weak, right? And even we are providing where we cannot even enter. It is even in the something like a conditions, squeezing ground condition, you note down the name, even in squeezing ground conditions, right? Where, that is a worst situation where 4 polling is used, where you cannot enter, right? If you open even a small span, that will come down, okay? There, that is a concept started from there, this 4 polling issue, right? And now, as a part of our Langwal, when you consider, now we are providing even chalks and all. In addition, even at the face, some spalling, face sprags and so many things we are providing, right? So where our, we are securing even the sides of our face, and also the roof, which is not supported by any bolting or any type of your chalk shield leg is there on the back, and it is something like a 4 polling, like whatever canopy is there extended like that. Okay. Otherwise, the correct definition is 4 polling is in the squeezing ground conditions. Okay. Now let us continue. Choice of mining method by whom? Chandan, Jyoti, Viswal. and the CR to coordinate with the time. He should not give more than
sir,
how much
I am presenting, sir.
How many are presenting today as per schedule and how much time, so that you divide that. CR to coordinate. Continue.
Sir, will I start?
Yes.
So I am Chandan. I'll be talking about the choice of mining methods. So next slide, please. So first of all, let's see the outlines of the topic. So today I will discuss about the choices of mining and processing methods. Choice of mining methods, what determines the type of mining, processing and consideration, and the difference between the surface and the underground mining. Next. Next.
Chandan, you can control the slides so that you can also change the slides, okay? I have given you permissions.
I am not able to. Okay. So, the choice of mining and processing method. The simple aim is selecting or implementing a process in which at the end of the day, we want to make profit without hampering the environment and taking all proper safety concerns, so that we don't, so everything goes fine and we earn money without hampering the environment. So next slide. So the choice of mining method. So what are the factors which affect the choice of mining method? To talk about all the factors, starts with the shape of the ore body, the orientation of the ore body, the continuity of the ore body, the size of the ore body, the depth from the ground to which the ore are present, the grade or quality of the ore, whether it is high grade or it is low grade, the distribution of the ore around the ore body, the depth of the overburden. It is very important in case of surface mining, whether the overburden, whether we should go with surface mining or we should go with underground mining, the strength of the ore body and the and the projected production rates, capital cost, rate of financial recovery and cash flow. So and also most importantly, the safety concerns and its impact on the surface, like environment, surface drainage and all. So next slide. Okay. What determines the type of mining? If you see what upon which mining we'll select, majorly the depth below the surface, the size of the ore body, shape of the ore body, grade and type of ore determines from we'll go with which type of mining. Next. So in this picture you can see like example of underground mining and surface mining. Underground mining are generally deep under the ground and they are usually small in quantity, less in quantity, but are highly rich in minerals. And surface mining are more shallow and near the surface. You just have to remove the overburden and go get to the ore body to remove minerals. So in this you can see that in surface mining we have to remove the waste and make dumps of the waste, and to remove the ore we need to there are various methods to reach the ore body, and like open pit mining and all. And in case of underground mining, we have to dig small edits and shafts to reach the ore body, and through which the ore body is extracted. Next. Talking about the major differences of the surface mining and underground mining, usually the surface mining disturbs a large area. It requires a large area to remove the, first we have to remove the overburden, then we have to also transport the overburden to a place So it also impacts a large area and environment. And in case of underground mining, it usually doesn't disturb a lot of area. Even 1-2 hectare of land would usually do for it. Surface mining produces a large amount of rock waste, but underground mining doesn't, in comparison with surface mining, the waste quantity is quite very less. Surface mining is relatively very safer than comparable to the underground mining. So the working conditions are better and the safety records are also better with less hazards and accidents. But in underground mining, there are chances of collapse, explosion, even release of sometimes natural gas gets released and may sometimes lungs diseases may also happen. The operating cost in surface mining is generally cheaper, but underground mining sometimes it's more expensive. Surface mining is more efficient, but underground mining is less efficient and there are chances of losses also. Next. Next slide. So surface mining and underground, what does it involve? Surface mining generally predominant exploitation method worldwide refers to two main types of mining, open cast and open pit. Both open cast and open pit mining involves digging a large pit in the ground down the surface level. The main difference between the two is the direction of mining. In open cast mining, the pit progresses across the landscape, while in the open pit mine, it deepens and widens but doesn't migrate laterally. But in underground mining, doesn't require a surface pit, but involves clearing rock space beneath the surface. If we compare the benefits of them, generally surface mining is cheaper with higher productivity. But in case of underground mining, is likely, if we consider the area wise, even 1 hectare at each side, because there is no surface pit. Only 7% of rock tonnage extracted is waste. If the mine waste is replaced back into the mined out tunnel, there is also very little surface dumping. Unfortunately, this is very common practice because of the additional cost involved. It is not very common practice. So, talking about the problems, what problems are faced in each type of mining? So, surface mining, there is huge environmental and social impact, because large amount of land is required. Even some local people may get displaced due to extensive mining from there in that area. So it usually causes deforestation and causes huge amount of rock waste compared to the underground mining. But in underground mining, if we talk about the problems, the safety issue is a major concern.
How much time you are taking?
Yes, sir. Sir, give me 1 minute. So in various accident may take place. If you talk about example, in 2007, around 220 people died in a fatal accident in underground mining in South Africa. So these are all the differences. Next slide. Next slide. So talking about the previous slide. Okay, thank you, sir.
So what was your title?
The choice of mining method.
Right. So I cannot give more than F grade or P grade to this, because everybody to note down. Generally, our purpose of this is to improve the skills of our beloved students. And that is to on the topic selected based on your interest. He should have presented about 30, 20, 10, whatever, with references from 2020 to even 2010. then what was written in different international journals and different national journals. And then while presenting, was talking about South Africa. We know from simple DGMS site are everywhere. What happened even in the last month, last year, accident or whatever it is, then you get lot of information. So he has not done anything. And one more thing is everybody should note down this. So this is what I would like to improve in you, that skill India to become Make India concept in National Education Policy 2020, whatever it is. There should not be any copy from others. You should not copy somebody's slide and then show here, or copy even, that is what is, it is illegal or unethical. That should not be there. And that's what, since it is a first time, no problem, but you will be given a chance to improve. He will be he will be presenting to improve his whatever is there. You will see others' presentations also. But all these things are very important. Nobody should copy, because a lot of materials are available, right? In the site, Google, whatever it is, okay? But on your topic, there should be minimum 10 years of the references. Your reference should be there in the last slide. From these references, I read about this, whatever, right? Then there should not be anything copied. It should be on your own language that you should learn. Then font size, and then while writing, you should be very careful, right? So that people should be able to do whatever you are writing on the slide, projecting is not you to read, but others to read, and you will be explaining on that important points. That should be there. And evaluation process, whether it is an international conference or Nobel Prize, whatever it is, right? So they never give more than 10 minutes for presentation. Okay, Siddharth, you wait just for 1 minute. I will finish this.
Yes, sir.
So, but everybody should note this. The evaluation will be based on 4 points, 4 pillars, whether it is a Nobel Prize or whether it is your national conference selecting the best paper or your best project award or whatever, right? Then it is the content, very important. Content that should support the title, right? And it should be given nicely. This is the introduction about that, whatever is the title given to you. And then on this, this is the literature 2020. I read in South Africa, it was done like this. In India, it was done like this. In Japan, in whatever, right? So because that is a topic of your interest, you must have collected whatever you collected. Don't worry for if it is not available, whatever is available, that should be kept in this fashion. Okay, so that content of the material is very important. Number two is this order of priority, how anything can be evaluated, is preparation of your slides, right? You should not give undue importance to some photographs, backgrounds, and so many things. It should be very clear whatever you want to say. Wherever photo is required, there only will keep it. Somebody has kept it, copied, pasted here. No, that habit, you should leave it if you have that. Okay, but you should develop the habit of writing on your own, and then in your style, not other styles being copied, right? But initially you can copy, but copy is also an art, right? You can copy from 10 papers, not from one paper. Right, that is what is a journalism, okay, right. That I wish by the time you reach up to final year, you will get all these skills. I wish that way. And initially, no problem, whatever you did it, let us encourage and go ahead. And next part is your presentation, style of presentation. First is a preparation. And then depending on the time given to you, importance of the topic, what you are giving more stress on that, and you will be coloring whichever is important, giving more color, bigger size. That's why I used to give you in between, right? With beautiful color of your pink, whatever, right? Okay. So your presentation style is very important. And then last is a question and answers, right? That is also part of it. I am not taking up because now you also let us acquaint with the system. Otherwise, at the end of this, that is the reason why there should not be more than 8 minutes presentation and 2 minutes for the question answers. And that is a purpose. Others should ask the question. Okay, now let us continue with Siddharth. Only today we will close with Siddharth only. let him not take more than 6 to 8 minutes and 1-2 minutes for your question and answers at the end. Students should make the question. I have been recording everything, what was presented, how it was presented, who asked the questions, and how the different grade, everything I used to maintain, so that this helps you to improve your skills. Okay, I hope you will understand that logic. Now continue, Siddharth.
Karthik, just give me the control, please.
Do you have the controls?
No, it is mentioned over here that request control. Continue.
Otherwise, no problem. Let Karthik play the slide, whatever.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Then you say next, then he will make the next.
Okay, sir. Sir, I present over here.
Yes, continue.
Okay, sir. My topic is basically about drilling in underground mines. I have given it with reference to the Nandira Colliery, which is situated in Talcher, which is a part of Mahanadi Coalfields Limited. Sir, before proceeding to the drilling part, we should know the purpose of drilling first. In mining, in specific to mining, we do the drilling for basically for the exploration as well as the production purposes. Exploration is based on our research at which depth the ore is being present. We collected the sample and like that we proceed for that. And for production, like we used it for primary development, like developing of inclines, declines, like that. And also secondary development is also done, as well as in production also, we also drill out the blast holes to produce. Next slide, please. Karthik, next slide, please.
Yeah, I am shifting to the next slides. Okay. I'm not you getting it?
No, that takes time. Don't worry. Okay. Because the depending on the connectivity,
okay, sir.
Even if you change, that takes some time to display. Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay. Sir, there are three pictures of drilling. In the first picture, we can see that this is a mineral, means exploration drilling is over here. And in the second picture, please back. In the second picture, we can see over here that the production is being made here. And in the third picture, there is a drill leg, means a pusher leg is being mentioned. Sir, here the components of drilling is being mentioned. There are basically four components of drilling. The drill machine, which is the energy source of any drilling part, and the rod, which is the energy transmitter of any drill part, and the drill bit, which is the energy applicator, and which is mainly used for the penetration process or for hole making process, as we can say that drill is basically the hole making process. And the circulation fluid is being used to cool the drill bit as it heats up to, as we uses up to an hour, so it heats up, that's why it cools the bit, as well as it stabilizes the hole. Sometimes air, water and mud can also be used for circulation fluid. Next slide, please. Hello.
Yeah, the next slide is mechanism and drilling.
It's time. Meanwhile, you continue to say about it.
Okay. Yeah. Sir, mechanism, in the next slide, we'll discuss about the mechanism of drilling. The drilling mechanism basically depends on the two factors, the penetration as well as the control. In the penetration part, it depends, here we can see the penetration part, in which it is the process of breaking or means disturbing the formation of making a chip. In the control, it is the machine specification part. Next, please. Next slide, please.
Just factors.
Sir, the next slide is about the factors affecting drilling process. Sir, there are basically two factors that affect the drilling process. There are two variables basically the operating variable and the independent variable. The operating variables are based on the machine specification, like it is, they are drill rod, drill bit, and circulation fluid. In independent variable, this variable doesn't depends upon the machine specification, rather than it depends upon the region topography, rock orientation, the drill hole factor, the borehole factor, the inclination, declination, the depth, and the rock type. Next slide, please.
Now, before telling to change the slide, Karthik can start changing the slide after keeping for only 30 seconds, so that others already, they must have seen by that time.
Actually, sir, I already have changed the slide. I don't know why.
It's not in our hands. That is a connectivity.
Sir, actually, it is being delayed. Actually, some.
I know that happens. It is not in our hands. That's why.
Yes, sir. This is the next slide. Sir,
10 seconds after that, you change this one. By that time, it is there. Okay, go on telling.
Sir, this is the type of drilling over here. We can see the drilling is basically divided into two types, the percussive and the rotatory. In the percussive, we can see that the
slide.
It is the mechanism of percussion drilling, in which it is based on the simple pulley factor, like that pulley mechanism only. If we'll release it, then it will go down. If we'll pull it, then it will come off. Next slide, please.
Keep a slide only 10 seconds and change. Go on changing.
Here it is mentioned about the percussion drilling, sir. Here we can see that it is a very fast,
which is collected by you,
yes,
and
sir,
which is not known to your students. Already you know about this in the last semester. Go yes, further. Sir. Give what is important, which
sir, important, sir, important. I have mentioned it in the form of a case study in the last of the slide.
Go to that. Leave all this.
Okay,
go to that.
Okay, move forward.
You try to make your presentation impressive and interesting to your audience.
Okay, sir.
That is a skill you should learn. Okay,
okay, go to the pattern of drilling. Go to the pattern of drilling, the cut.
Don't show all these things which have no reference, no nothing important.
Sir, they are having reference to the reference to the Nandira collieries only. Means the
only
equipment part. Sir, the equipment part only I have going to show.
Continue.
Sir, this is a jack leg, or we can say. Okay.
No, tell about this.
Previous one. Karthik, the previous one, the pattern of drilling.
Don't waste time.
Pattern of drilling.
Nandira.
Okay, sir.
Jack leg, everybody knows. What you want to show in this?
Sir, this one the
drilling वाला नहीं इसमें क्या दिखाएगा
आगे चलो आगे सर दिस वन ड्रिलिंग पैटर्न यूज्ड इन माइनिंग मींस दिस टाइप ऑफ कट्स मींस द पिरामिड कट
दिस इज द स्टूडेंट्स व्हाई यू आर शोइंग दिस गो टू नंदिरा यू डोंट हैव एनी रेफरेंस नथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस
Sir, in Nandira Collieries, as I have already mentioned that it is in the Talcher area of Mahanadi Coalfields Limited, and this project was basically started in 1962 by NCDC, and the underground
only
work.
Only drilling you talk about it.
Okay,
don't
sir.
Talk other things.
Okay,
only
sir.
Drilling.
Sir, the underground
work. What is a drilling pattern? Go continue.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. The underground working over here. Oh, underground. Okay,
don't
next slide.
Other things only drilling. Drilling is your topic.
Okay. So this colliery basically uses two UDMs, means universal drilling machines, as this has an advantage of moving its arm to 360 degree. That's why it is being used over here. The WP3 panel, which is in the Nataraj mines of Nandira Colliery, engages an UDM for both the roof bolting as well as drilling of face shot holes used for the solid blasting. Here the roof bolting operation is done through hydraulic roof bolter, in which 22 mm of hexagonal drill rod in combination with 27 mm of PDC drill bit is being fused on the top of the jack leg. Then sufficient water is being provided.
You have its figure? Go to next slide.
No, sir, I don't have its figure, but I have collected the information.
Should not read that.
Sir, okay. But I have collected the information about this thing.
So, now Siddharth, time is over. Okay. So, Siddharth, whenever you prepare for all others also,
yes,
your figure should be self-explanatory, right?
Okay,
and then you should not show which is already known to all your classmates, right?
Sir, but proceeding to the class,
drilling which is done, you note down. You people have to repeat, right? In 1989, there was a drilling department started in CMRS, right?
Yes, sir.
And that was aimed at improving the drilling efficiency, okay? And then Scoble and Peck, you note down the names. From McGill University, they did a lot of research. Even computerized drilling was done. In 1988 itself, I used to prepare international journal papers. Not general conferences for our teachers at that time, right? You should talk about what is the latest happening as far as the drilling is concerned. And then there are so many varieties of drills used in the world. You should have shown those things. Understand? And all the references from 2020 to 2010, at least last 10 years, references about the drilling. It will not take more than 1 to 2 days or 1 to 2 hours, right? So this is the way how you should make your slides and your information content should be as desired. I already told you this is the purpose why we introduced and our students got benefited out of improving their beautiful skills of presentation, skills of collecting material, skills of preparing the document, skills of preparing PPTs. Okay. I hope in the next classes, there will be more improvements. If you are not done, you do it and then resubmit to your CR so that your improved PPTs will also be there with the CR. Okay, now with this today, who is going to summarize? Now let us go to any CEP answers or summary. Summary by whom? So that we should not go into others. Class timing. Now it's already 9. Summary by whom? Karthik, Yogita madam, if they are absent,
yes,
then
sir.
Respond. Then summary, give summary. Yogita madam.
What okay, we discussed? Sir. Today we started with coal winning and evacuation operation, which include cutting by shearer, armored face conveyor, crusher, gate belt conveyor, truck, trunk bells, and at last bunker. Then we discussed about hard roof management, which decisions were made for implementing stability and effective strata control, how to manage yield pressure.
Okay, no problem. Nicely said. Next class, we will continue with the presentations in an improved style, and whoever might have prepared, they can also improve upon that and then submit to your CRs updated things. And this is the way how we would like to improve our skills in our Skill India and National Education Policy 2020. You must have seen we are preparing a good document, National Education Policy 2020 for mining education, and that's what you must have seen in the board also. Okay, then all the best for today. Let us close
sir.
It. Yes, Karthik, if Hello. You have any doubts, you can ask.
Yeah. So what will happen of the number of remaining students of today's allotment?
They will be in the next class. That will be moved like that.
Sure.
Don't worry, you must have made a serial order. Now remaining,
yes,
we start in the next class with them and others will follow like that. Okay, don't worry for that. Okay. Any other doubts? Now, all the best then. I think you must be having some class. Otherwise, I can continue so that we can utilize this time. Shall I continue if you are not having any class now? Yes, no?
Sir, our next class is started.
Oh, achha. That's why let us stop it for today. Okay, then. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Take care of COVID-19. Help your parents.
Yes,
I'm stopping recording now. All the best. Jai Underground Mining. Aur kya bol rahe hain?